Hello and welcome back to Bitwig. Today we're taking a closer look at EQ Plus, the flagship equalizer of Bitwig Studio. Its tangible interface and pristine sound quality make EQ Plus a flexible tool for mixing, mastering, and sound design in Bitwig Studio. Let's locate EQ Plus in the pop-up browser and get started. The spectrum analyzer is already active in the background, displaying both pre- and post-signals, while this rainbow line in the middle represents the EQ's filter curve. By clicking and dragging from this line, filter bands are set up and tuned. Each band is represented by a numbered dot, which you can drag across the frequency spectrum and into positive boost or negative cut. Up to 8 bands are available in each instance of EQ Plus. You can also just double-click anywhere in the display to create a band right at that spot, or remove it with another double-click. When you hover near the edges of the display, the mouse cursor changes to indicate filter types more commonly used in these areas. This way you can quickly add shelving filters at the curve's edge, or a high or low cut near those extremes. Or a notch, right at the bottom of the display. And you can always change the filter type by using the mode menu, down beside all the other properties of the selected band. While dragging a filter, you'll see how the numerical values for frequency and gain are changing. The color of the controls is changing as well, following the frequency setting of the band, and an additional cue to help match the visual with the audio. This third value, which has stayed constant now, is the cue or quality factor of the band. It describes how steep or flat the shape is. Holding the Alt key while dragging a dot gives you a more handy way of changing the Q factor in combination with the frequency, while keeping the gain value constant instead. Another way to adjust Q and frequency together is the secondary handle with a double arrow, which you'll find on any EQ band. While you click and drag it, you'll additionally hear this specific band in a solo mode. This helps you to really focus on the sound of that band, as it isolates the affected area while you edit. Any selected band can also be heard in solo by clicking the audition icon, down here by its properties. Or you can bypass the band, using the icon right next to it. So there's multiple ways to set the parameters of any filter. And you can always pick the one that's most supportive for your current situation. An interesting option regarding the Q factor is adaptive Q, which you can toggle up here in the top right corner. When enabled, each band gradually gets narrower as the gain is increased. This non-linear style is common on analog mixing desks and a bit more musical. We maxed out the gain at 10 dB. But that's because of the range setting up here. While the 10 dB range is best for fine-tuning, you can extend the range up to plus minus 30 dB to allow for more radical EQing. If we go back to the 10 dB range now, any higher gain filters will likely be outside the display. So for the more ambitious EQing jobs, you can make good use of the expanded device view in EQ Plus and its large full-range display. Here you can do all the edits that we looked at previously, but in greater detail. A right click on a dot also lets you change a filter mode, right here in the display. So you can really do all the tweaks and settings on your EQ Plus here, without ever going back to the device panel at the bottom. In fact, you can also hide that to make the EQ display even larger. Otherwise, in expanded view, the device panel shows a neat overview of all the 8 EQ bands and their properties. A nice option of any expanded device view in Bitwig Studio is to undock it to a floating window, to make your workflow even more flexible. And as we speak about customizing the user interface, EQ Plus also makes use of the inspector panel. Here you'll get another overview of your EQ bands, as well as settings for the spectrum analyzer. For example, the freeze speed may be useful when trying to see a moving spectrum's footprint. You can also add an external reference signal, shown as a purple curve. This is a handy way to complement another track and avoid filling the same frequencies. And as with any device in Bitwig Studio, the interactive help view of EQ Plus will remind you of these details without interrupting your workflow. Let's finally also look at some more unique features of EQ Plus. For instance, we have a global shift parameter up here. This shifts the entire EQ curve, and it does it in musical semitones. So if our source material is based on notes, like this sequence of C3 that trigger the sampler, and we have already set up EQ Plus to cut out some of these loudly ringing frequencies that the sample has at this pitch. Now if we transpose the incoming notes, let's say 5 semitones up, our previous EQing might just fall apart. So if we shift EQ Plus by the same amount, we can easily fix the problem. Let's not forget about Bitwig's unique modulators, which are available on any device or plugin, including EQ Plus. For example, since note messages are passed all the way down the device chain, we could adjust global shift dynamically with the incoming notes. By adding a key track modulator here, with the root note set to C3, and assigning it to the full range of the global shift, each note in this sequence will get its own individual treatment of EQ Plus, as the curve now adapts to the incoming note. Another popular mixing technique is sidechaining. With the audio sidechain modulator, we can use the drum loop to modulate the low cut on our pad sound so that it doesn't fight with the kick drum. With a versatile toolbox like modulators, various mixdown problems can be solved, and they provide free rein for sound design experiments as well. Please note that any instance of Bitwig's basic equalizers can be upgraded to EQ Plus using the right-click menu. We hope you enjoyed this tour of EQ Plus and Bitwig Studio. Now carve up some sounds and we'll see you soon.